45, Paris 10 hostel. Just made breakfast. Good night's sleep. Great place to stay. All right, looking forward to the day.
All right, it's a little bit after 7. You can just kind of see it's getting a little light out there. There's the dog. Probably see some coyotes out there here. So I'm gonna get going. Back on the trail. A little windy, but gorgeous morning. Mile 1006. So it's about 7:40. First section of trail that's not completely covered with rocks, so I thought I'd do a little snippet. So for today, we're just going south to US 50, about 14 miles, and finish up the roller coaster. Had a great experience at the Bear's Den, chatting it up with just some second hikers, no through hikers. Great place, great hospitality, very enjoyable. I'm glad I went there on a Sunday night. Apparently they had 300 people camping out in their fields over the weekend, so the place was quite packed. And I was able to get the last available bunk in the bunkhouse, and it certainly was a great respite. So the Bear's Den certainly should be on the list for consideration if you're coming through this area. All right, so let me put the phone down. I started off slow and I'm gonna finish up slower. Mile 1005. Kind of see through the trees, the valley. I swear the colors have changed over the past few days, so really cool. Mile 1004. Tough climb, a little bit of a view. Almost at another one of the summits of the roller coaster humps. And guess what? Back down and do it again. Pretty red colors. Mile 1003, and going down in elevation, you can see that the leaves aren't changing as much. Looks like I caught the fall at the perfect time, but just by chance, serendipity. Sam Moore Shelter in spring. Gonna go fill my water bottles, eat something, and push on. Quick stop at the Sam Moore Shelter again. Nice picnic table, peg to hang the water bag. And there's the spring again, loaded up with 1¾ liters of water. Reconfigured some gear. Got 11 miles to go, but too early to declare victory, and slow and steady. Mile 1002. Mile 1001. Nice easy section, but definitely not off the roller coaster just yet. Back in February, I was hiking in Yosemite, and there's a Park Service janitor emptying out the garbage, and he expressed how fortunate he was to work in such a national treasure. And he says, every now and then, I need to remind myself to look up. And so I'm looking up and just came in to these very, very large trees. Got up at least 150 years old. A lot of the areas that have been hiking, the trees have been knocked down and they don't look to be too healthy either. So remember to look up, but don't forget to look down. Coming up on the mile marker that needs no introduction. There's a pileated woodpecker. You can barely see the head. Mile 999. Back to three digits. Seven to go. And then four left on the roller coaster. Way too early to declare victory. Mile 998. Mile 997. Just got to the top. And I looked at the profile and it shows a pretty steep gradient going down. So, not done with the roller coaster just yet. Watch out for the log. Way too early to declare victory, but done with the roller coaster. What a ride. You talk about some puds. You go up, you go down. Good job, trail boss and crew. Mile 996. Yeah. The ups and downs are not nearly as much. Grateful for that. That roller coaster, definitely an attention getter. Just took a little break, sat down, pulled out the sit pad, which I don't leave home without it. And ate some oatmeal and drank some water, mixed up some Propel, and reminded myself to tap the brakes. Even though I'm done with the roller coaster section, you know, I was feeling like a barn sour horse and started picking up speed and had to remind myself to slow down. I recall a few years back, I was in Afghanistan. I was working out with this lieutenant, feeling pretty good. And then the gym was about a mile away from our barracks. So we had to run back and I'm saying, man, I'm keeping up with this guy. And going a little faster and then snap. There goes the hamstring. So slow is the new fast. Coming up on this stone wall and this thing's gotta be at least 200 years old. And this is some serious handwork. Wow. Mile 995. And this trail is in a high state of maintenance. You can tell somebody's been through here trimming along the trail, and I'm not going through a car wash. Mile 994. Mile 993. Less than a mile to get to the trailhead, get to the car. Just kind of summarizing the last 4 days, three nights, 68 miles on the AT. A yo-yo from US 50 up to Harper's Ferry and pulled the string back. Back down to US 50. A couple takeaways. Eat on the economy when you can. You don't have to carry food. So I ate at Horseshoe Curve Restaurant off of Route 7. And then I ate at Harper's Ferry. And then at the Bear's Den. So didn't have to carry as much food. Plenty of water along the trail. This was definitely very physically demanding. So 68 miles in 4 days, that's what, 17 miles a day on a trail, plus a little offshoots to get water and just walk around Harper's Ferry. Key things to keep in mind: if for some reason you watch these videos and you're like, I'm gonna go do that, well, make sure you're in shape. I've been working out pretty hard the last 2 months, and then also shout out to Michael and Nancy for feeding me some good food for the last 2 months. So fueling the engine. And then appreciate Paulie's comments keeping me honest on the trail. She's always one to chime in, so I appreciate her attention. And then heard from Richard in Japan. I know he has been keeping tabs on Traveling Beat. He's all over the place. So some other takeaways: when you're in the canopy, your Garmin inReach is gonna lose power. Didn't have any issues, but it'll drain the battery a lot faster. And then no gear issues. Footwear okay. Hook of Speed Goats good. My Black Diamond FLZ trekking poles stood up. Everything seemed to work out. I used all my gear, including my rain jacket and rain pants, because I needed something to change into when I was getting my clothes washed at the Bear's Den. So, if anything, having that spare set of clothes, so you got something to change into. I will say, grateful for the Bear's Den. What a phenomenal place. Great hospitality. And then also shout out to the person there that found my other sock in the laundry, so I don't have to go buy another pair of socks. Just found out about that place last week. So really cool place to visit if you're on the trail, or even if you're not on the trail. Glad I went there on Sunday night rather than Friday night. Apparently there was hundreds of people camping out, and everybody and their brother was there. So great long weekend. Glad I was able to do it in terms of schedule, and then physically able to do it in terms of capability. You know, you get to level 50 and above, and that check engine light keeps coming on, and I think it's solar powered because I tried to unplug it and it stays on. So I'm gonna do what I can while I can in between other responsibilities of LIFE. So almost to the car. Get to play Frogger the last time on this trip. Nice, clear. 4 minutes. All right. Last crossing. Calling this mile 992 on the Appalachian Trail. Finishing up the hike. Let's hope the car starts. Mile marker, signing out.